humbly accept my apology, Mr. John Laurinaitis, Senior Executive of Talent Relations.
Executive Vice President.
Executive Vice President of Talent Relations. I'm sorry. You came here to wish me luck?
I did.
I find that hard to believe. Why don't you run along and go talk to your husband, the new COO of WWE? Or, you know, better yet, why don't you go wish your daddy luck? I mean, I know he doesn't run day-to-day operations around here anymore. Thank God. Yeah, more or less, you're pretty clueless. But I didn't say it. You did. I called you idiotic. I know where that hand's been.
There's a lot wrong with that. I mean, obviously, I don't think they're saying Cena sucks. I think they're saying CM Punk. But you get the gist of it, right? And for everything that's right with that, thank you, Dwayne, for sending that from your Facebook, by the way. You're a phony, like he says. But the ironic thing is, while he's calling you a phony, he doesn't realize he's just as big a phony as you are. He seems to have a real problem with you. I don't want Dwayne to talk to me in a voice like this and say mean things about me, so maybe I'll just stop. Here's the thing, John Boy. 7 years ago in Los Angeles, you walked in and you won your first WWE title. Congratulations. This Sunday, you're walking back into Los Angeles, and I want to let you know something. You're walking out with nothing. You are walking out with nothing. Oh, sure, you'll be a big star the next day. You'll be in the Marine Corps, or maybe you'll have your big fight with Dwayne, which is great, and you'll still have your legions of fans who are going to pee in their pajamas every time they think about you. Luck's for losers, and I would much rather be a one-hit wonder than a phony. I mean, how many times do you tell people what to do? Wait, you know what? Don't answer that question. Answer this question. How many times did you say, well, you know, I just don't think he has what it takes, while you're lying in bed with your wife? In that vein, I actually have a clip from a big-time movie star that is going to explain in so many words how I feel about John Cena. And no, that movie star isn't you and the chaperone.
How was your movie, by the way? I missed it.
Mine went straight to DVD, just like yours. Don't really answer this. It's a rhetorical question. If Triple H asked you to jump off a bridge, would you? Because I think that would be good for business. You want to see the text message my little sister Shalene sent me last night? Here it is. OMG, Kevin Nash, WTF, thought he was dead, LOL. In anybody else's hands, this is a microphone. In my hands, it's a pipe bomb.
Yes, we are still alive. Welcome to another installment.
Two weeks outside the ring.
Oh my God.
Somebody out there was having withdrawals, even if it was you, Jason.
Yes, absolutely. Speaking of Jason, I am the one and only. Jason!
Bye-bye!
That's right. As you notice, there's one person saying my name. We'll get to that in a second. Yep. I'm sitting alongside Troy. Stone Cold.
Oh, hell yeah.
Austin. And there is nobody else here.
Our trio is a duo tonight.
Yeah, Wes.
Wes is in Tennessee.
Wes is filming Thunder in Paradise with Linda Hogan. He is not here. He is with his girlfriend's family. I just got off the phone with him.
He's doing the Christmas, New Year's thing, whatever.
Apparently.
Vacation.
He's not here. So as you could tell by the start of the show,
it's going to be a CM Punk kind of night.
It is. It is a special edition of Outside the Ring. What the hell? Wes Burton's not even here.
This is our New Year's edition. This is going to be kind of our rendition of the Slammies. We don't have
no BS.
We don't have a name for them. Yeah.
No.
We don't have categories that are tailor-made for one person.
Right. Well, stupid trophies.
We have one category that's like that.
Yeah.
We'll get to those later, though.
Yeah. So we got a bunch of categories. It's the best of 2011 from mostly WWE. There is some TNA stuff.
A little bit of TNA thrown in there, because let's face it, TNA, there was no best of anything in there.
This is going to be a hard show, because usually we do a three-man thing.
Yeah.
We're going to be talking a lot.
Yeah.
Because definitely. Wes usually goes over a lot of the Raw stuff, so yeah, we're not going to go over Raw.
We're not going to go over Raw, because honestly,
you know what happens. You probably don't care.
Biggest thing that happened on Raw was Kane kind of explained why he attacked Cena.
Yes.
And
that's really about it.
About it, yeah.
Raw sucked. That's why we're not really going to talk about it.
Yeah.
Why bother? Next week will be good.
We're not going to go over any of the ones that we missed either, because if you haven't seen it by now, then you,
watch it on YouTube.
Yeah, if 99% chances you know what happens. Yes. So we're not going to do that.
Let's get our shameless plugs out of the way.
Boy, can't go a day without those.
That's right. Outside the Ring with the number one on Twitter. On Facebook, we are Outside the Ring. Our email, Troy?
OutsideTheRing316@gmail.com.
And you see us right now on YouTube, so keep subscribing. We need subscribers.
Like this video. Share it with your buddies.
Yes. Now, we do want to say that our next episode of Outside the Ring will be taped this Tuesday,
yes,
which
we will
is
be
what,
back
the
on
third?
Our...
the third.
First is Monday. Second is Tuesday.
Or no, first is Sunday.
First is Sunday, yeah.
So the
third.
The first, the new episode.
We will be back in the new year.
Yes, the first episode of 2012.
We will be back in supposedly the last year any of us are going to be alive.
Now, this is up on New Year's Eve, so Happy New Year. And, yeah,
10,
don't drink a
nine,
bunch of beer.
It's not that time yet.
They might be listening during that time.
Don't laugh at that. Be safe. Don't be stupid. And don't go out driving when you're drunk.
That's right. And, yeah, other than that.
That's about that.
It's about time. Let's go headline! Look at that spike on the microphone. Wow. Wow. Okay, so... officials are working on Randy Orton's return. Randy Orton got messed up.
Yeah.
What was it, last week? During a house show.
It was a house show. And then they played it off on SmackDown.
With Wade Barrett doing something that Orton did to Mick Foley.
Basically murdering him.
Yeah. Orton kicked Foley down the steps. Now Orton giving a little taste of his own medicine, and he got thrown down the steps. So now they're talking about, well, what can we do with Randy Orton at the Rumble? Sources are saying that they're already, it is in St. Louis, his hometown.
He was originally, at one point, he was set to win it.
Yes, and now that can still happen, apparently.
Don't you love it, though? You know, Orton goes to St. Louis, and he can win the Royal Rumble.
Yeah.
Beth Phoenix goes to Buffalo, gets buried by Kelly Kelly.
Very true. That's why I still don't think Randy Orton's winning, but maybe we're wrong. You never know. Now, officials are discussing, well, have Orton maybe come in like a late surprise entrance,
yeah.
Keep him off till TV till then, and then when he wins it, heal up all the way to WrestleMania.
Yeah,
that's going to be hard to do to book a match.
He's going to be out until, at least from what this is saying, they're thinking about having him out until the Rumble.
Mm-hmm.
Come in, you know, number 29, number 30.
Yeah.
Win it with minimal effort, because he'd still be injured, and then have him off TV until maybe like two or three weeks before WrestleMania.
And we'll see. We'll see what they do. It's a big blow to WWE to lose Randy Orton.
And
Alberto.
Alberto's out. He pulled his groin.
That was not a work. That was legit on Raw when he was in the wheelchair.
They did, you know, kind of play it up a bit on Raw, but he is injured.
He's hurt. That is two big guys they lost.
The one thing I did like about on Raw, Ricardo was in the neck brace but still had the bow tie.
The bow tie was on the neck brace. That was so awesome. It was like when Mick Foley used to bring out Sacco, and Sacco wore the bow tie.
Or like he had the referee stripes spray paint on his shirt.
Yeah, yeah. I thought that was really clever. it was kind of funny.
Okay, and this next.
This thing is hilarious.
This is funny. Can I do this one?
Go ahead. You wrote this down in the headline sheet, so go ahead.
We're both the gamers, but.
This is funny. This is bad, actually.
The headline is former. Where was I? Oh, yeah. There's two stories here. Former WWE star to join TNA and news on Hulk Hogan's video game. The video game first. Official Xbox magazine named Hulk Hogan's main event the worst video game in 2000.
Congratulations, Hogan.
Yes.
It's so bad.
The magazine writes, and this is verbatim from the article.
Yeah.
This atrocity earns the loudest jeers from us for not only being the least interactive Kinect game to date, but also wasting a great idea, mimicking lavish pro wrestling entrances, and taking up precious landfill space that could have been filled with something more pleasant, like hazardous waste.
Wow. Wow.
This game would have been a strong contender for the year's worst game if it were a $5 Xbox Live Arcade download, but at $50, it's the financial equivalent of being smashed in the head with a steel chair.
Oh!
Hogan, your game sucked, man.
Well, I think
you would have had a better shot at making another TNA Impact game than that.
I mentioned
atrocity.
It to you off the air. I said, you know, if honestly, the only reason this game even sold
because it had Hogan's name.
I'm sure somebody bought this game. There had to be people
somebody
that went
bought
out and
it. And there's got to be somebody out there that likes it. And
oh, look, it's Hogan. I'm buying it.
Yeah, I mean, it was Hogan that sold that. Period. It wasn't the interactive gameplay.
Oh my God, I've never played it, but I've seen it in stores, and you're thinking to yourself, this could be fun, but apparently it's not.
It's taking up precious landfill space that could have been used for hazardous waste.
And then as you mentioned, Chavo Guerrero is probably set to join TNA early next year, and we'll see. I mean, he's already tweeting about it, and he apparently was at one of the tapings already.
It says here, former star Chavo Guerrero is expected to join TNA Wrestling in the near future after appearing for Ring Ka-King.
And can you explain what that is to everybody?
Ring Ka-King, if you don't know what it is, number one, literally translated in English means King of the Ring.
Mm-hmm.
And this is TNA's India promotion, the one that Jeff Jarrett has left to run.
Right.
If you look up the roster for it, it's almost nothing but WWE, former WWE superstars.
And like
Chris Masters, Chavo, who else? Nick Densmore, Eugene.
Trevor Murdoch.
Trevor Murdoch.
Just Harry Smith.
Yeah, it's just... wow.
And I guess already, alongside Harry Smith, Guerrero captured the promotion's tag team championships at the taping. So Chavo and the Bulldog's son...
Chavo and D.H. Smith are tag champs. Matt Morgan was the Ring Ka-King.
Well, you would think Matt Morgan better get the damn belt in that organization.
He was their first champion, but Brutus Magnus has it now.
Oh, does he?
Sir Brutus Magnus. Sorry.
Oh, lordy.
Yeah, but hey. Hey, honestly, from what I've heard, some stories that this India promotion got better wrestling, got better reactions.
Really?
Got better crowd reactions than TNA itself.
Why not?
It got better ratings in India. That's bad.
But let's face it.
That's good for TNA,
bad for us. Right, but WWE still owns that market in India.
God,
they own the world.
Yes.
This is WWE,
the only place in the world that they have competition is in Japan with All Japan and New Japan Pro Wrestling.
This is an attempt by TNA to basically say, hey, we're worldwide too. That's all this is.
That's basically what they're trying to do.
That's all this is.
If they're worldwide, they need to start, you know, broadcasting everything.
Yeah, pretty much. So the new Batman movie looks pretty tight.
Oh, God.
The trailers are out. Maybe we'll post it on our Facebook.
Did you hear the thing they did for the people in IMAX?
No.
It was in very select IMAX theaters a few weeks ago. They played the first 7 minutes of the movie, the prequel.
Wow.
Or the prologue, sorry, not the prequel.
Holy cow, that's cool.
But yeah, they played, it was only in the IMAX 43 theaters. It's like the really high-end IMAX theaters.
Now, wrestling fans,
And it was like not even 50 theaters around the country.
Oh, wow, so only a certain amount of people got it. Somebody with a camera probably taping it on YouTube right now.
I did this stupid thing, and I tried to find it on online. You cannot find it.
Nobody has it.
Christopher Nolan, the director, made sure that did not get out.
Wow. Now, we're mentioning this because it is wrestling-related. TNA star...
It's not...
Pope.
Yeah, Pope D'Angelo De Niro.
He had a small role in the movie.
Yeah, he's one of Bane's henchmen.
So that's cool.
That's kind of cool. I mean, it shows that the TNA stars are getting into the movies.
Yeah.
Hopefully they'll be doing better than John Cena. I guarantee that De Niro's part is going to be better than any Cena movie.
I think that's sad, actually. That's really bad. So that's really it. That's all your headlines.
That movie, it looks so good. And Anne Hathaway in tight leather. You can't go wrong
with that.
Did
you notice? I know we're totally off topic in wrestling. But did you notice in that trailer she never wore the Catwoman uniform? She's in the trailer, but she's not.
She is Catwoman. I've seen pictures of her in the uniform.
Oh, really?
Yeah. But they haven't released it in the trailers yet. I think they're trying to kind of hide that because, you know, that's their sex appeal for that movie.
That's where Wes Burton is. He's looking for pictures right now in Tennessee as he films Thunder in Paradise.
He's looking for Anne Hathaway in tight leather.
Oh, Lord.
Anyways, that's your headlines.
Yeah,
now we
much.
Get into our... what do you want to call these?
The best of 2011. No, the OTR...
The OTR...
Best of.
This is the OTR year-end special.
Right. Now, we put this together for about an hour. We went through different categories. Where do you start? We were actually thinking, let's just get in here and talk about 2011. It's hard.
We have 13 categories. We have lucky 13 categories.
This was a decent year for wrestling. I thought it wasn't the greatest.
No. It wasn't the greatest, but it was good.
I say we start at the bottom and work our way to the top.
Bottom? I want to save that last one for last.
Okay. Okay, but we'll start near the... You see where I'm saying.
Mm-hmm.
First up, Tool of the Year.
Tool of the Year. And the winner is... Michael Cole.
Who knew?
He is the biggest tool in the company.
And that hurt. Tool of the Year goes to Michael Cole for numerous amounts of things. It could also go to the social networking. By WWE this year. The Twitter, they started the whole Twitter down your throat things probably about 3 months ago. But now it's really bad.
No, it's been more than three.
Well, yeah, 2011 is going to be remembered for Michael Cole being very annoying.
Yeah.
Michael Cole being shoved down our throats more than John Cena.
Yeah.
I think.
Yep.
And
Michael Cole burying talent. He's burying your world heavyweight champion.
Yeah. Yeah,
Cole,
and if you go back...
When it comes to Daniel Bryan, Cole basically sticks his fingers in his ears and says, la, 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 I can't hear you. What you say don't matter, la, la, la.
Yeah, that's why we picked Michael Cole. Just the reasons there.
He's a tool.
He is a tool. He's a jabroni.
He's a tool. He's a douchebag.
He is. And if you go back to early 2011, the Lawler feud and then the Jim Ross feud, that's still going on till this day. On New Year's Eve, 2011, you could go back to the early start of 2011. Michael Cole, from January till December, has been down every wrestling fan's throat.
People that don't even
watch wrestling that much, when they turn Raw on, they're like, who's this guy? He sucks. Where's Jim
Ross?
I
know people that have turned in, saw Michael Cole, listened for about 2 minutes, and changed the channel. He's that annoying.
Yeah. So there you go. Tool of the year,
Michael Cole.
There you go. What a bitch.
He doesn't get an acceptance speech.
No, but he got a beat button right there. There you go.
Next category, biggest enigma of the year. And we both agreed that it has to be the January 2nd promos.
I think most fans would agree. Yeah. I don't know who you...
Of course, another enigma of the year could be, what the hell happened to the Raw Anonymous General Manager?
I'll tell you what. And as we go through this, comment on our Facebook, our Twitter...
Twitter comments on the video itself.
On the video here.
And let us know what you thought of all of this.
Outside the Ring, number one, Twitter. Facebook, Outside the Ring. There you go. There's my best Michael Cole impression.
The biggest enigma is either the Raw General Manager pertaining to where the hell did it go.
Yeah, list all these. We'd like to know your feedback.
The January 2nd promos, because it can be used for so many people. Is it going to be Undertaker? Is it going to be Jericho? People have said it might be Skip Sheffield and his new Ryback gimmick. Mm-hmm. It could be Batista.
I'd be okay with Jericho. I'd love to see Jericho.
That's the best way it could turn out.
Batista would be kind of cool because we haven't seen Batista in
a year and
a half. But
like I told you before we got on air, we've got Mason Ryan, though.
They would just drop him. Because as Batista wasn't a great wrestler, he's damn well better than Mason Ryan.
He is. He can definitely...
Batista got pretty good.
Batista can definitely work the mic, I'll say that.
Mm-hmm. Batista's not bad. And I'd like to see Batista back.
Yeah.
I think, honestly, at first I was like, yeah, it wasn't that big of a deal. Then I'm like, you know what? He actually was pretty cool.
Yeah.
He had a good entrance, not when he was a heel. It was kind of...
No, that...
But when he was a
just
face...
Walk out with the single spotlight.
He had the music.
Yeah.
He had the look.
Yeah.
Batista was the... He was the whole package. I mean, he really, like I told you...
He wasn't no Lex Luger.
No. Oh, God, no. He's leaps
the total
and bounds
package.
Better. Whatever. Yeah, whatever.
Batista could cut a decent promo. Luger couldn't.
Yeah, but we agreed. Is the Raw GM thing, that is an enigma. But I think if you're...
The biggest one has to be the January 2nd promos.
We're going to find out this Monday.
Yep.
New Year's, the day after New Year's Day.
Yep.
We'll find out who could it... You think they'll save it till the end of Raw? Or do you...
They'll at least save it till the second hour. I don't know.
You got it.
I don't know if it'll be the very last one, but
will it just interrupt somebody? in the ring.
Could be.
Like The Rock and
like
Jericho.
The Rock
was
and
perfect.
Jericho, yeah, when Jericho first debuted. Yeah,
yeah, that's but yeah, what it could be.
Biggest enigma of 2011 is the January 2nd, 2012 promos.
I agree. And again, tell us what you think. List yeah. all of these categories on our Facebook, our Twitter, our YouTube page. We really want to know what you think.
Yeah.
Because I'd like to know, because you might not agree with us.
Exactly. The next one I thought of, and you agreed with me.
I totally agree.
The best promo video of the year.
Now, what we. When we say best promo video of the year, we're talking about any promo that's building a wrestler.
Building up a specific star, not a feud, mm-hmm. a person.
A star.
Yeah.
A wrestler.
Like what you like they had, Kofi Kingston had a promo video a
yeah.
few weeks before a match.
Right.
Wade Barrett had one.
Right.
The Brodus Clay promos, which we still haven't seen it.
This video.
And if this 2012 turns out to be Brodus Clay, I'm going to scream.
Oh. We'll talk about that as we end the show.
Stupid.
Oh, I have yeah,
the,
some.
The,
I
the
thought,
promo
just
videos,
thought about that.
The promo videos have to be building up a specific wrestler.
And in 2011, there was one guy.
One.
The Miz.
Yes.
The
his,
Miz.
His promo at WrestleMania 27.
With Nas.
Where he was, with
you
Nas.
You can hate me now.
You can hate me now. Sitting in the production booth
mm-hmm.
with the TV monitors,
mm-hmm.
looking back on his days in the real world, comparing
yeah.
it to now.
It was
to his
awesome.
Days first starting. Yeah, no pun intended
no.
there.
Because it starts with Hulk,
yeah.
and then it starts
it's,
with Rock,
yeah.
Austin,
it
through the years.
It starts with these people that he looked up to that
yep.
made him want to get into wrestling,
yep.
and then it shows him on the
progressing.
Real, it shows him on the real world
mm-hmm.
talking about, I'm going to be a pro wrestler. All the other people are saying, you're an idiot, Mike, you're not going to make it. And
mm-hmm.
then it shows him pinning Orton to win the
win
title.
The belt.
And, you know, he can literally
the music
take,
was good for it. It was
yes.
perfect.
He can, the Miz can take all that he's done in his life and shove it in the face of everybody else that was
JBL.
On the real world with him. JBL included. And I
mm-hmm.
like JBL, but JBL, from the reports, was a real dick to to Miz.
There you go. Nothing says the holiday spirit like a beat button. Two beat buttons in the first 15 minutes.
Wow. But yeah,
I agree
Miz,
with you.
The promo, his promo video, WrestleMania 27, was our pick for best promo video.
And they saved it for WrestleMania.
And
I thought
honestly,
that really
yeah,
made it
that really made
sweet.
It made it just that much better.
They could have did it on Raw the night before.
It wouldn't
but
have
they didn't.
It wouldn't have meant as much at on Raw.
I agree. Now, that WrestleMania 27 where that they debuted that promo, we also had the worst entrance of the year. Ladies and gentlemen, take a guess. John Cena.
Yeah. The choir was just way too much.
We agreed. We thought one of his better...
You could even hear it during the entrance. People booing. The Cena sucks chant.
John Cena is now like The Undertaker. Every year he has to have this big, glamorous
long,
entrance at WrestleMania.
Well, a lot of people did. Triple H did it. Taker did it. Shawn did it. It's WrestleMania. They go all out.
Yeah, but...
But Cena has the unnecessarily
the
long
ones. Right. That's what I'm saying.
I will admit, though, his gangster entrance
with
was
CM
awesome.
Punk on the
CM
car.
CM Punk was hanging off the
car. That was
car.
His best one.
Yeah.
I would think that was WrestleMania 22.
One. And the one with the Mustang. I don't remember which one that was.
Yeah, that was WrestleMania. I'm almost positive we could look it up online. It was WrestleMania 23.
I was thinking it was a Royal Rumble. But
well,
I
here's why I think
wrong.
I think it was WrestleMania 23 because it was at Ford Field, Ford Mustang. And they
okay.
drove past. Okay. I just remember him driving past the Ford Field.
Yeah.
And it was a cheap plug for Ford.
Yeah.
That's the only thing big shout out to Ford, by the way. We love your cars. Yeah, worst entrance of the year by far, 2011,
yeah,
was the
John
Cena.
It was
bad. It was a quiet. It looked like we were in church, and then John
yeah.
Cena came out.
And John Cena came out, and like, oh, yay.
Honestly, I thought at first it was cool when they did the, it was DMX, and he was saying, you know, I do what I do. You can hate me
yeah.
and all this stuff. And
yeah.
it started off kind of cool, but then when
and
the choir came out, it was like, huh?
Really?
Singing your song, John? Really?
Stupid.
So there you go.
And then on the opposite end of that spectrum,
same WrestleMania.
The best entrance of the year, same WrestleMania, goes to Triple H. The
I
Metallica
agree.
Fits
For
so
whom
well.
The bell tolls.
It fits so well
yeah.
with his feud with Undertaker.
Oh, it was great.
The entrance with him in like the Warriors garb
mm-hmm.
with the other Warriors around him.
Yes.
The lights went out. Then he was just.
Time to play the game.
Time to play the game.
It was.
It
awesome.
Was, yeah.
It was very cool.
Yeah.
It
and
was.
Again, remember, all of these are our opinions.
Right. If you think
let
it was.
Let us know what
hey,
you think.
If you like
I
the
mean,
Cena entrance,
honestly,
let us know.
The Miz had a decent entrance that year because that promo video was part of his entrance.
Yes.
It played the promo video, and then it showed the big inflatable awesome.
Right, and
stage,
he came through it with
he
Alex
came
Riley.
Busting out with Alex Riley.
And that was good, but I like you kind of said before, the video was great. The entrance was it was the Miz.
Yeah.
But it did lead up to the Miz being cool.
The Miz isn't a flashy guy.
No. And then, like, the entrance was, for Triple H, like you said, was just, it was unbelievable. The Knights,
yeah.
the King of Kings, that whole ordeal. It was so much better than the one he was doing when he was on the chair.
Yeah.
When the King of Kings theme first debuted.
He was playing, like, the Conan the Barbarian
when
role.
He fought Cena.
Yeah.
This one was better. It was so cool.
Yeah.
It was so cool.
Definitely.
So there you go. Best entrance of the year, Triple H. Same a lot of WrestleMania 27s here.
Yeah.
Most improved superstar.
This was a four-way tie.
And we could probably add more.
We could probably add more. It was a four-way tie between Zack Ryder, Cody Rhodes, Dolph Ziggler, and The Miz.
We put The Miz in, and because, we talked about this earlier.
Yeah.
The Miz, during 2010, was starting to build.
He was starting the build. 2011 is when it really kicked in.
Mm-hmm.
That's when he really got on the roll. That's when he won his first world title.
Right, which was in January.
Yes.
I think he won. Had to be. It was before the Rumble because he fought Orton for the belt at the Rumble.
Yeah, and he beat Orton for the title. So, yeah.
It was in January.
It was early this year. That's
it was
all
very,
all
very
really
early.
Know.
And this whole year, he's gotten better. And better. And now he's one of the main, he's probably the biggest heel in the company.
Aside from Cole and Vicky. But of course, that isn't that. They get cheap heat.
Miz gets pops.
Yeah.
Like when he was in Cleveland, he got a pop, obviously.
Miz gets cheers, and his heat is legitimate. It's not cheap.
Michael Cole, they did a taping from Texas, and he is a Longhorn, and they booed him there. Okay, Miz comes to Cleveland, Miz gets cheered. There's some kids that boo him, but if you know he's from Cleveland, hell, I was just in his by his high school the other day in Parma,
there you go.
Ohio. The guy, you know, they have shows about him in Cleveland. They have him on the news all the time. He always gives back. He's loyal to the sports teams, which is crazy.
Oh, hey, LeBron, if you're listening, take a hint.
Yeah, so.
Oh, yeah, LeBron James listening to our podcast.
All
what's
we,
the point of that?
Hey, big shout out to LeBron.
For what?
You're right. Go Kobe. take that.
Right there. Didn't miss a thing.
Woo! I definitely did not, by the way. So, yeah, The Miz has gotten better as the year has went on.
Yep.
We
and
totally agree with
Ryder,
that.
With Ryder, Cody Rhodes, and Ziggler, those really speak for themselves.
I met Dolph Ziggler, and I'm a little biased here. But out of all of them, it's either... Cody... When he was with Orton and Ted DiBiase, Cody, you could see the potential back in 2010.
Cody really didn't catch my eye, and I really wouldn't even have considered him for this until he lost the mask, until he went to his current gimmick. Because I realized
his feud with Booker is good.
It's better than what
I thought it was going to be.
Is. Because when he had the mask, it was a really cheesy character.
It reminded me of Jericho / Orton.
Yeah, it was a really cheesy character, but you could see that he was trying his best at it.
Yeah.
He was just working with what they were giving him.
It was like, he looked like Rip Hamilton from the Detroit Pistons. He always had to have that stupid mask on.
Yeah.
Years after, you know, it was like a year.
Yeah.
Because last WrestleMania, not 27, but 26... That's when he debuted that mask. He had it for about a year.
Yeah.
I mean, it was way too much.
It kind of reminds me of D'Lo Brown. You know how he had that
chest protector? Yeah.
And then finally somebody said, hey, wait a minute. That's an illegal object.
Duh. You know? I agree. Yeah, but now, you're like you said, he is starting to get that it factor.
Yeah. And now, Dolph.
What can you say?
Dolph has been on the uphill for the last 4 or 5 months.
Even if you go back to January of 2011, this year, when he was feuding with Edge.
Yeah.
He had a world title shot then.
Yep.
And he took Edge to the limit. And
Dolph Ziggler will hold the world heavyweight title in 2011.
I agree.
I am saying
it. Or 2012.
It, or 2012. I'm saying it
I agree.
Right now. I'm almost willing to put money on it.
Dolph Ziggler would be a cool champion, and here's why. We have CM Punk and Daniel Bryan right now with the belts, which is cool.
Which is so great.
And
I would love to see a champion versus champion
people
match.
People could hate on Vince all they want, but Vince, you know, hey, thank Vince, because he's actually starting to listen. Whether it's Triple H in the office now, I don't know.
It was like...
They're listening to the fans. The wrestlers, the best and wrestlers are having
Punk,
the belts.
Punk went on an interview for WWE.com, I think, right after Bryan won it, and said...
times are changing, something like that.
Something along the lines of, we're just a couple of... we're just two indie schmucks.
Right.
Look where we
Look
are
where
now.
Look where we are now.
It's something along that line.
It reminded me of Benoit and Guerrero when they both won the belt.
When they both won at was it 25? No, 20.
It was the big one.
20, yeah.
No, a killer triple threat match. Probably my favorite match of like all time.
I remember that. That,
Benoit,
that,
HBK,
that scene
and
at the
H.
end
was
after
great.
Eddie won and Benoit... Or,
it was Benoit. I remember. Benoit made Triple H tap.
Yeah, and,
Benoit
then,
won the belt.
And then Eddie came out and they both celebrated in the ring. The confetti was going. The pyro was going.
It was nuts.
It was great.
It was hyped so well.
Yeah.
That's what it reminded
because
me
they
of.
Were
these two
such
guys.
Close friends.
Yeah.
It's just a shame that we've lost both of them in the past, 8 years?
Yeah, not a year. But Dolph has that it factor.
Dolph definitely has that.
He puts on good matches with anybody.
He has that it factor. He's excellent in the ring. He's one of the best.
Mike's skills are underrated.
He's one of the best sellers in the company.
Mm-hmm. He sold the RKO very well when he faced Orton the other night.
He sold the RKO
a couple weeks ago.
He could
really
sell
good.
The sweet chin music like
Hell,
nobody's business.
He put Zack Ryder over, and I thought when he took the
Rough Rider,
the Rough Rider, the way he did it, it looked awesome. He sold it very well.
Very well. And you know, Ziggler, again, like you said, his mic skills are extremely underrated.
He's starting to get out there now.
He is.
He's more and more. And, you know, Vicky, she gets that heat, but you know what? I can see her with Dolph with the belt. She's a good antagonist. She's one of those heel. She's a good heel manager.
She is, but
she's annoying. But
she is holding him back a little bit.
A little bit, yeah. I could see that. I could see the argument for that. So yeah, Dolph Ziggler. I agree with you. Out of all these guys on this list, if I had to bet money right now in Vegas, Zack Ryder, Cody Rhodes, Dolph Ziggler. I mean, take the Miz out. The Miz is going to
be
champion.
The Miz will
in 2012.
Yeah, he'll be
probably.
Somewhere. He'll
somewhere.
Be there. That's a given.
That's a given. But if you take out him and just Cody, Zach, and Dolph.
Dolph will have the title before any of the other ones.
Yeah. Cody
is mixed up with Booker T right now.
He's Ryder, on his way.
I don't know what they're doing with Ryder.
I can't see Ryder with the world belt.
No.
That would be too
I
much.
Honestly can't I, ever see him. And I'm not saying that because I don't like him. He just doesn't have that
unless
factor.
He changes that gimmick.
Yeah.
I can't see a guy
and,
from the Jersey Shore with a world belt.
While we're on Ryder, he, as much as I don't like him, he did improve a lot.
Oh, yeah. And if you look at, I mean, look at back in 2011, early 2011, guy wasn't at the Rumble, I don't believe. He was not at WrestleMania. He was in the little thing with Snoop Dogg. At WrestleMania.
Where they were looking for... Yeah, he was singing Rebecca Black's Friday.
This guy, yeah. Friday. Woo, woo, woo.
Yeah.
There you go, Wes Burden. That's for you. Never again. Yeah. This guy has improved, like you said, tremendously, thanks to getting himself out there, kind of like we are, on YouTube.
Yep.
And he wasn't even on Raw probably until, what, May?
Something like
of this
that.
Year?
It was it was just about halfway through the year. And in 6 to 7 months, look where he is now.
I'd say either Dolph or Zach.
I'm going to say Dolph simply because Dolph has now... he's in the main event.
Yeah. Cody,
he's gotten that
God
push
bless
a little
him,
bit further.
But if you're talking most improved, like I said, Cody was relevant in 2010 with Orton and Legacy. I mean, this is... Yeah, I agree. It's either Zach or Dolph.
Zach
I think
or
you
Dolph
flip
is our
a
most,
coin.
Most improved superstar. Flip a coin. And our next category
Ooh-wee.
Is... Oh, God. Disaster... This is actually awards.
Two awards. Yeah.
This is the disaster of the year and the worst match of the year. And it goes to Sting and Jeff Hardy from Victory Road. Can you really even consider it a match?
This was back in March of 2011.
This was terrible. Hardy shows up.
Main event. This was the main event. He was high. Man. Jeff Hardy was high. Nobody drug tested him. Nobody... all blame Jeff Hardy, but
from what I heard, he showed up late and basically went straight to the ring.
Yeah, nobody stopped him. That's how the management, and again, say what you want about Vince and his drug testing. This would have never happened at WWE pay-per-view.
Never.
Ever. Somebody would have been, Jeff Hardy would never have been allowed back, period, in a discussion. And whoever let him in the building would have got fired too.
Fired, yeah.
And This was the main event. And you got a guy like Sting.
About, what, 90 seconds?
The respect. Sting. If you're wrestling Sting.
The icon.
The guy. Sting. The one of the greatest of all time, hands down. You're wrestling an icon and you show up high.
High off your ass.
Yeah. It's a slap in the face to pro wrestling.
It's a slap in the face Sting. To Sting. Yep. It's a slap in the face to the fans.
Yeah. Yeah.
Especially the ones that ordered that pay-per-view.
Can you imagine paying, was it $40 for a TNA pay-per-view?
Yeah.
And the main event.
And the main event lasted a minute and a half, and it ended because Jeff Hardy was too high to do anything.
I remember watching the next day.
If
it was all talked about everywhere.
If I would have ordered that, I would have emailed TNA and I would have demanded my money back.
This award was easy.
You're going to reimburse me somehow.
I think
give me $20 to TNAshop.com.
That's what they did. They gave people some like free points to shop TNA.com.
I know that
they
did issue a formal apology, which I give them credit for that. Because, I mean.
Why? They let this guy back in the company. I lost hope with Jeff Hardy back in 2010.
That is what pisses me off, that he is back in the company.
Yeah. Just like
after he did,
in a big spot,
after
nonetheless.
After he did 10 days in jail for getting caught for all those drugs.
Yes.
I'm going to quote Ric Flair.
Uh-oh.
I hate Jeff Hardy.
Yeah. Yeah. You're a liar. You're a cheap.
I'm not going to punch myself in the forehead, though. Make myself bleed.
It was really bad. Absolutely worst match of the year. Not even hands down.
It's
worst match in history, almost. It's close. As bad as Kane and the Great Khali was a few years back, at least they tried.
Remember Zeus?
And nobody was. Oh, God. Hogan and Zeus was bad, if you want bad. So there you go. Return of the year.
Disaster. It's the worst disastrous match.
Yeah.
Sting and Jeff Hardy.
Return of the year is not even. There was a lot of guys.
There was a lot of honorable mentions, but Booker T, by far.
Lillian
Garcia, Kane.
In the mask.
But yeah, all those are honorable mentions. The return of the year, hands down,
The Rock.
The Rock.
The great one. Period. It's not even close.
Period. Yeah, there's no competition.
The Rock
Again,
came back.
We have honorable mentions to Kevin Nash, Booker T, Lillian Garcia, and Kane.
Yeah.
Because Kane reinvented himself again. Booker T, always good to see him in the ring.
It was cool. Nash, cheap pop at the Rumble.
Yeah.
Same with Diesel.
Nash was basically for nostalgia reasons. And Lillian Garcia, she was a great ring announcer. She's got a great singing voice.
It's good to see her back.
And honestly, those are about the only returns this year.
Rock
was by far
we
the
haven't
biggest
seen him.
Return.
It was 7 years
exactly.
since he's been in the ring.
And he proved to us that after 7 years...
He still has it.
He still has it.
In the ring, too, nonetheless.
No ring rust at all.
None. He did all his spots.
Okay, I will... When he first got physical, he tried to do that nip up and he missed it. He slipped. That was about the only little bit of ring rust.
But I think
that he
fixed
showed.
That at Survivor Series. I don't think
he was flawless at Survivor Series. He was great.
It was one of those things where you haven't seen the guy for 7 years. He comes out during a Raw where we're trying to figure out who's the guest host. And the way they did it was so smart. They had, if you remember back in February of this year, they had the woman get out of the car with the high heels.
Yeah.
And they showed her getting out of the limo. And you're thinking, God bless it, it's not The Rock.
Yep.
Then the lights go out. They have all this buildup. And if you smell what The Rock is cooking plays.
Did they ever address who that woman was?
No. Never. But the way they did it was everybody I remember.
Ooh.
Huh.
She... From the 2012 promos,
I'm
really stretching it here.
You're really stretching it.
But maybe it's the woman that got out of the limo.
Maybe
I don't know.
Anyways,
okay,
but they never.
The
they've said, "Ooh, who's this?" You know, and they're showing the legs
and
the
feet. Never.
And you're thinking, oh, God, it's Lady Gaga or something.
I'm guessing in reality it was Stephanie.
It was probably just like, hey, let me see your feet.
Yeah, really.
You know?
We got some random lady from the thing. Hey, we'll give you $100 to step out of the limo.
I remember I was on Twitter that night talking to people, and I'm like, God bless it, man. They let us down. Again, this is not weird. Because everybody thought it was The Rock.
Yeah.
Like, because The Rock's on Twitter now on Facebook. He never had those before, and you're thinking,
exactly.
Can it be The Rock? Can Rock? They're in California.
Yeah.
You know? And it's this buildup and buildup all night, and you see this woman get out, and you're like, oh, my God. They sold out to a Hollywood actress.
They screwed us.
Uh-huh. And then, like I said, the music
hit. The music hits.
It was the biggest pop I've ever heard.
Justin Roberts says, here's your host for WrestleMania 27. That music hits, and the crowd
insane.
Crapped their pants with joy.
it wasn't even, yeah, crapped your pants, you know, marked out. Whatever, I marked out.
Whatever,
I
you,
was
want,
on,
whatever you want to call it, you were happy about it.
I gave
it.
Somebody, some jabroni, one of my rent, you know, one of my neighbors, a people's elbow that night, and a rock bottom threw off the balcony. I was ecstatic. And then his promo, and then the build-up with John Cena.
Yes.
Which we'll get to.
Yes.
But it started right there.
Yep.
So there you
shocker
go.
Shocker of the year.
Yeah, shocker of the year. Something that you were like, holy crap.
Yeah.
What the hell happened?
Well, three, really. The third one, really, not so much.
Mm-hmm.
The real shocker of the year is, of course, Edge retiring.
Edge retiring was huge.
Yeah, it was.
Nobody saw this coming.
No.
Nobody.
Edge didn't even see it coming. And he went to the doctors, and they said, hey, if you keep wrestling, you could die.
They had it basically on Raw. They had this thing where, you know, they even start the show off with it.
It was the Raw after WrestleMania, wasn't it? Or it was
a couple months.
Couple months, okay.
It was like 2 months. I don't remember exactly. But they show, you know, this match, and then they're showing what's to come up on Raw. And all of a sudden, you see Edge, huge announcement. And yeah. I'm thinking, okay, is it a storyline with Alberto? Because he was feuding with Del Rio.
Yeah, he was thinking, you know, is he going to, you know, make a Hell in a Cell match or something like that.
And then he comes out and
they never hinted towards
none. You see him start breaking down in the ring and you're like, oh my God, he's going to retire.
Yeah.
Like, you knew right when he came out.
You could see it in his face that, he was, you know, this was not Edge. This was Adam Copeland talking to you. Mm-hmm. He even said that during the promo.
Yeah.
Right now, I am not Edge.
Yeah, I'm Adam Copeland. And, you know, breaking down, and it was like a 20-minute thing. You said goodbye to the fans, and then they had a SmackDown send-off. Like,
yep.
And that was it.
And then
he
returned to confront Christian.
Yep.
No
he
physicality.
Did nope, he did that.
He just basically said, Christian, you're
but
not
he's
the
done.
Same.
He's yeah. done. I he, can't see him he, ever having another match. Stone Cold I can, because Austin's in good shape, and his
Edge
his next
could come
heel.
Back in a non-wrestling role.
Like a GM or something. But I can't see him, like I said, like Stone Cold, where Stone Cold's got, he's got bad legs, whatever, his neck.
Yeah.
But he is actually recuperated from a lot of those.
Same with Shawn Michaels.
Edge is really messed up.
Yep.
Edge has he's had that neck injury, I think. He's had two surgeries on his neck, I believe.
Something like that.
His legs, like Shawn Michaels, exactly. He's come back.
Yeah, Edge was the big shocker of the year.
The second
shocking moment of the year was Daniel Bryan cashing in. The Money in the Bank.
And then winning the championship. Yeah. We said it all year. He's going to be the guy that cashes it in and loses.
And loses because Vince hates indie guys.
But he won.
He won it. Yeah.
He won.
He cashed it in twice and won it, really.
Yeah.
But then Teddy Long says, oh, Mark Henry isn't physically fit to wrestle.
And you know,
wrestle,
and I felt
blah.
So bad for Big
I
Show.
I felt so bad because, well, I felt bad for Daniel Bryan the first time because he said, oh, Henry wasn't.
Right.
Wasn't.
But why
I felt bad for him there because the first thought in my mind is, okay, that was his quote-unquote win. He's going to be the first to
lose.
You
know what? You just mentioned a guy that we could have nominated for most improved superstar, Mark Henry. There's a guy that...
yes.
There's another guy.
Yep,
I don't think he would have... Well, he's close to being up there because he won the world title.
Yeah.
So I'm sure somebody's already commenting going, hey, Mark Henry!
Hell, we could have put Daniel Bryan in there, too.
Yeah. And
of course, Daniel Bryan, people know he's good.
Oh, yeah.
And if you deny it...
Well, character-wise, he even got better, though.
Really. And if you deny that Daniel Bryan's good, you
you're
need
an idiot.
Smack in the head.
Smack in the face.
But,
I don't think
him winning
close.
The championship, didn't see it. I remember watching that SmackDown.
Mm-hmm.
Or was it a Raw? Yeah, it was a Raw. Because I remember
When he
won it.
No, it was SmackDown. It was SmackDown. And then Teddy Long came out. And that's how the show, remember, because Teddy Long came out and said, hey, player, he's not able to go.
No, I'm talking about he actually won it, not the second time.
Oh, it was TLC. It was the pay-per-view. Big Show gets knocked out after, and then you're like, oh, God, Daniel Bryan's coming.
Yeah,
Big Show.
I'm thinking, you know, is he going to do it? Then I thought, nah,
it's the Big Show.
A face versus face, no.
But they did it.
And then his music hits. And my eyes kind of got wide.
Like, oh, God.
He came in, and I saw him cash it in. I saw Big Show wasn't moving.
Yeah.
He cashed it in. They rung the bell. They counted three. I was sitting on the floor. I jumped up. I'm not even
oh my God.
Exaggerating.
Like, they just gave Daniel Bryan the world championship.
Exactly. And I know there will be people out there, people like Michael Cole. Oh, he's a hypocrite. Oh. It doesn't count. It was a cash-in.
It's a storyline. Who cares?
Does Cole remember how Miz won his first world title?
Apparently
not.
The
exact same friggin' way.
I know. It's bad. But I kind of felt bad for Big Show in that estate. Like,
yeah. Like,
why not have him pin Mark Henry? I mean, they had him pin.
They're trying to protect Mark Henry. They're
I guess
building
so.
Him as this...
Yeah.
Humongous monster.
Yeah. And I guess it could lead to a Big Show heel turn.
It could.
Change him up
and
a little bit.
I can understand that Big Show is mad. I mean, it was his second world title in how many
but
years?
But he did tell Daniel Bryan to do it on a SmackDown two weeks ago. He said, take advantage,
he even
kid.
Said, he even said, you know, he said, I take some responsibility. I tried to make him do it. And then he turned around and did it on me. So
right.
I guess turnabout
and
he
even
kind of
smirked like, son of a gun, you know, after the match. But
honestly, you know, if Big Show, you know, he has a rematch. Okay.
Yeah. Which is this week, right? Is that on SmackDown this week or next week? I think it is.
I don't know. Honestly, what Big Show should do, let Daniel Bryan have his time. He should come out and just say that and say, you know what?
So no heel
turn. I don't
even
care about the rematch.
I don't think he can turn.
This kid deserves it. I'm just going to let him have it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because who do you... And then you got him feuded with probably Mark Henry or whatever.
Yeah, yep.
Maybe Sheamus coming
up. And that was the second for Shock of the Year. And the third Shock of the Year, like I said, this one really isn't much. But the WWE Network is actually going live in 2012.
So is this going to be like the USA Network and all this? Is it going to be its own channel?
It's going to be its own channel, I'm guessing. But you're going to have to pay for it. And from what I've heard, it's only going to be like $7 a month. I can swing that.
I'm going to get it. I'm going to get it and see what it's...
Because I want to see...
Hell, NFL Network is $7 a month.
I want to see this WWE Legends house.
With
I know
Mean Gene.
Mean Jim, sorry.
Yeah, Mean Jim. Who knows? I think it'll be good.
It should be good. Plus, all the old stuff they're gonna be showing AWA, ECW, WCW.
That's what I think it's gonna be good.
Yeah,
I mean, yeah, you have a lot of the DVDs.
Plus,
and
if
the
they're
tapes,
gonna go
but,
through with what they said about the pay per views, that's gonna be nice.
Yeah,
all the pay per views minus the big four will be shown on the network
after they air. Pretty much.
Oh, live.
Really?
Because you're paying for it every month.
Oh, well, hell, that's great. Well, there you go. $7 I'm paying.
Exactly.
So there you go.
Well, remember, that's just from what I've heard.
Right.
I can't really confirm that or not. But
now we're getting to the big three.
Yep, the big three.
The match of the year, the story of the year, and wrestler of the year. We start with match of the year.
We'll lead up to the big one. These are our top three matches of the year. Number three... Orton and Christian.
Take your pick.
Yeah. I liked the one at Extreme Rules.
The SummerSlam one was fantastic, I thought.
The one that ended with the jumping RKO onto the stairs. That's the one I
That was SummerSlam.
That was SummerSlam.
That's when Orton went over.
Yeah.
Yep. That was good.
That was my favorite match.
I honestly think that they were a contender for Feud of the Year.
Yeah.
They had a very good feud.
Do we have Feud of the Year?
No, we don't, but there you go.
There you go.
There's another one we're going to talk about that's just as good. I think they got a lot of play. They built this feud. They had a ton of matches, but every match was good. Every match. They didn't have one stinker. Not one.
Nope.
Even when, you know...
Of course, it did get old with Christians. Just one more match.
It did, but when you have good wrestling, you're like, you know what? It's okay.
It doesn't matter.
It's okay.
Exactly.
They could wrestle.
Yep. So that's our number three.
Yep.
Number two... is Undertaker Triple H at 27.
I thought that it was a good storytelling.
It was good storytelling. The match
was subpar.
Was all right.
It was above average.
It was still one of the best matches of the year.
It was definitely one of the best matches. It was probably the best match on WrestleMania 27.
Yeah, definitely. definitely.
It was better than Cena and Miz from that show. It was good.
Great storytelling.
It was a very brutal match. It took a lot of bumps.
It was Triple H... basically saying, you know, you retired my buddy, I'm going to beat your ass.
Yeah.
That's basic. You retired my buddy.
Yeah.
Kick your ass.
And Undertaker, after the match, basically, well, Taker wins, but Taker's staggering.
Triple H even brought that up. Triple H says, you know, the streak is over. Undertaker could not leave the ring under his own will.
That's why you're thinking, could be another rematch this year.
Yeah. which I really hope not. It was a good match, but it wasn't that good.
No. But it was definitely out of this year, it was one of the ones you're like, exactly. Yeah, it was really good. Yeah, and then and the story and the built up for it was really good.
Yes.
The built up with Shawn Michaels getting in there as well.
Yeah.
I thought they built it up real good.
Yep.
And of course
number
the winner,
one match of the year, CM Punk and John Cena.
And now, money I know, in the bank.
Yes, I know that people will say, oh, it's John Cena. He's never had a good match. Bull crap.
Yes, he had a good. He did have a good match.
It takes two people. It takes two people to put on a good match.
And give him props.
And these two people put on an excellent match.
It was in the last. This is different because the last 2 years it's been Shawn Michaels Undertaker hands down.
Yeah,
the best match of the
definitely.
Year. The last 2 years have been like easily Shawn Michaels Taker one.
Exactly.
Shawn Michaels Taker two.
Exactly.
This year, Cena and CM Punk had, without a
money
doubt,
in the bank.
There were so many near falls. There were so many back and forth. And the good thing, the beautiful thing about pro wrestling, if you can do it right, is you could tell the story during the match,
exactly.
like Triple H and Undertaker
exactly.
did. But they built it up. It started slow, and they built it and built it. And then the near falls, the pin attempts.
It was that snowball. It was the snowball effect.
They
started slow, and it just kept building and building and building and building. And that climax hit, and it just exploded.
Yes.
That sounds kind of dirty, I know. That sounds really dirty, I know it does, but I think you people know what I'm talking about.
There you go. But yeah,
that was, we both agree that is our number one match of the year.
The SummerSlam match between the two was a good match, but this one was the best match.
Yes.
John Cena's probably, other than the match with Shawn Michaels at WrestleMania, this was his best match ever. Might be better. I might like it even more than that one.
Yep.
But awesome job.
Match of the year for 2011 is Cena and CM Punk.
Yeah, and we said match of the year with John Cena.
Yeah,
if you'll like it,
tough. Fine. Well, you ain't gonna like the next one then. Story of the year, Cena
and the Rock.
It's a tie.
This is hard.
Cena and the Rock, which is self-explanatory. Over a year built up, and it's tied with the summer of CM Punk.
Where do you go? I mean, this
CM Punk is...
It's a coin toss.
It is.
This is what I... We talked about it before we got in here. This one is way too hard to call.
I can
go either way.
I mean, yeah, there will be people out there that are biased. Like, oh, I hate CM Punk. It's Cena and Rock. Or,
yeah.
I hate Cena. Blah, blah, whatever. This, again...
What do you talk about at the water coolers at work?
Let us know what you think.
Right.
Go to Facebook. Go to Twitter. Leave comments on this video.
Mm-hmm.
Let us know what you think your story of the year is.
It's
because
hard.
Because we cannot decide between Cena and The Rock and CM Punk.
Yeah.
CM Punk's whole...
CM Punk with Triple H. CM Punk with Kevin Nash. CM Punk with Del Rio. Laurinaitis.
The whole pipe bomb thing.
With John Cena.
The breaking the fourth wall. Mentioning Colt Cabana. Acknowledging the fact that Vince surrounds himself with yes men.
Yeah. It was such a... The promo, obviously the promo of the year, if you were going to do that, it was CM Punk.
It was CM Punk.
Hands down.
Yeah, the initial pipe bomb.
Everything was CM
Punk
on
that
year.
Raw.
Yeah.
That was the promo of the year.
So coin toss on that. And of course, as you could tell,
the wrestler
of the
year,
CM Punk. I mean, it's not even... We don't need a drum roll.
Yeah,
you knew
no drum roll. From the last two, you could see...
Which is crazy because I'll tell you what. If you would have got all the way up until about May, I would not have said CM Punk.
Yeah.
CM Punk was with Nexus early this year in 2011
and going nowhere, really. Nexus was just a stagnant pool.
It was a genetic... It was a generic... group.
Yeah.
With the whole new Nexus. It was already done. Nexus was already done in 2011.
That was one of the biggest disappointments of the year.
Yeah, I agree.
Well, that was actually one of the biggest disappointments last year.
Yeah. But
Nexus debuted so strong.
From June, end of May, June, through the end of 2011, CM Punk, hands down, took the ball and ran with it.
Yep.
And one wrestler of the year. Not even close.
Of course, these aren't any official things.
No,
so
this is what we think.
It's not like we're sending him a trophy or anything.
No. Thank you very much. I'm via satellite. No. But, let us know what you think. We'll put these categories on our YouTube page or whatever,
in the
video. Copy them and then, give us your thinking and your thoughts on this. I just don't see how you cannot give Wrestler of the Year to CM Punk.
Yeah.
he was involved in so much. When the guy has the microphone, you watch. I mean, whether you John like him or Cena, hate him, you watch it.
John Cena improved too. He's not Wrestler of the Year.
I agree.
He was in the running, but he just didn't come close to Punk.
I agree. CM Punk, hands down. Even the match that him and Triple H had, no holds barred, was good.
Yeah.
The both matches with John Cena were good. Even the one on Raw with John Cena, that's underrated. That was good. The Alberto match at Survivor Series was good.
Yep.
And the storytelling, promo skill-wise, the guy is the best in the world.
Punk and Dolph Ziggler.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you could—wrestler that could have been Randy Orton— It could have been.
You put Punk in the ring with almost anybody, and it's going to be at least a decent match.
It could have been a lot of guys, but hands down, CM Punk.
Yes.
So there you go.
That was
2011.
Nope. We got one more.
Oh.
We got one more.
Oh, God.
Remember.
Yes.
Remember, I said I wanted to do this one last.
Yes.
This is the worst year.
Yes.
Basically, the train wreck of the year.
Like, you really want 2012 to hurry up because you hated 2011.
You want to get 2011 out of the way
because
it just flat out sucked.
And we feel bad for this bro.
This award goes to Hulk Hogan.
Yep. Where do you start? Linda bashing him.
Linda McMahon. First of all, the divorce.
You said McMahon. God bless Linda McMahon. She didn't bash nobody.
Oh, God. No, Linda McMahon is a saint compared to Linda Hogan.
Linda, I do not deserve the name Hogan.
Exactly. did she divorce him this year or last?
I don't know, because Linda, she's been bashing him for three years.
Who knows? But, yeah, Hogan has just had the worst season.
Season. Yeah, brother.
Brother.
Where do you start? TNA being crappy.
Yeah.
He's involved with that, unfortunately.
Even though he hasn't been on TV.
Right. He probably don't want to be.
And then you've got Linda taking him for more money in the divorce.
Saying he's gay with Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
Saying that he had gay relations with Brutus Beefcake. Saying Linda coming out and saying that Hogan would beat her.
Yeah.
You know, drag her by her hair.
Hulk Hogan being related with the Xbox video game for Kinect. Any way, shape, or form, the worst game of 2011.
Hulk, that was a bad decision.
This was a bad year for Hogan.
Yeah, it...
Now, hopefully, on a positive, I think he did get married this year to his new wife.
I think.
It was either... Yeah, it had to be this year.
You mean his new wife that looks exactly like Brooke?
Yeah. So that was kind of...
Just like Linda looked exactly like Brooke?
Yeah, it was kind of... That was kind of like a positive for Hulk. But other than that...
Nothing.
His crappy reality show with the midgets... You know what I'm talking about.
I know.
Midget wrestling.
I've watched it simply because
Hogan just signed bad contracts with people.
Yeah.
He's got to get rid of that. Whoever his agent is.
Micro Championship Wrestling.
Yes, whoever his agent is, get the hell out of there. Give him a leg drop, the big boot, and get him out.
If Bischoff is telling you that these are good ideas, punch him.
Seriously. Hulk up. Hulk up and just, you.
It's, Hulk Hogan.
And you know what?
Ultimate Warrior.
We got to mention one other thing.
Hulk,
since you're
I'm sorry for you.
Have a good 2011, buddy. Yeah. I'm going to drink a beer for you tonight.
Hulk, I really hope your 2012 is better, man.
No kidding.
Because you have been through hell and back this year.
The one thing we do got to mention, since we are on Hogan, one of his best tag team partners one of the best teams of all time.
Yes.
The Mega Powers.
This
was shocking.
I know that we've lost more, but this was the biggest one.
Macho Man.
Randy Savage was
the one and only Macho Man.
One and only Macho Man. It lost him to a heart attack.
/ car accident. Yeah,
it was a heart attack, I think.
You're right about that. I think that's what killed him.
I don't have the article in front of me, but he had a car accident, and then he had a heart attack. It was complications from the car accident, and it was either a heart attack or heart failure or something.
This tore everybody up.
Yeah.
This was like a Friday afternoon, and it was a nice day outside, and all of a sudden you go to your computer, whatever, it was on Yahoo, it was on AOL.com, everywhere.
It was almost like when Eddie died all over again.
It was so bad, and just an absolute tragedy, because Macho was not that old.
No.
And
he was still in pretty good shape.
And I'll tell you what, there's another thing bad for Hogan. I mean, this guy was one of his best friends.
One of his best friends.
And they did, and it was good to see, and I'm glad I read this article that Hogan and him got patched up.
It really surprised me. that WWE did a tribute to him.
Yeah,
and, you know,
because they have
him were
Vince,
not on,
no.
on great terms.
He's got to go in the Hall of Fame 2012, right?
He's got to be the big name next year.
I mean, I know
he
Rock is in
be.
Miami, but
he
we can hold off for
be.
The have the
Rock can
next
go
year.
In 2013.
That's what I'm thinking because Rock's already wrestling.
Yeah,
And I know it's in Miami. I know, I get it, but Macho deserves a spot.
Yes. Yes.
And again, like I said, I'm glad Hogan and Macho patched up their differences.
Yeah.
That was good to see before he died. But unfortunately he
Vince,
never
Vince
yeah,
and
like
him
you said.
Never really got the chance to. And I'm guessing this was kind of when the WWE did the tribute, it was Vince's way of saying,
hey, I apologize. I'm sorry.
I know it was a little too little too late.
Yeah.
But still it was something you don't see often, and that's Vince McMahon showing compassion.
He is one of the guys that if you say Hulk Hogan, you know nothing about wrestling, you know Hulk Hogan, you know Macho Man Randy Savage was a wrestler.
Even if you know him because of that crappy rap album.
Mm-hmm.
If you know him from the Slim Jim commercials.
Yep.
What you still know Randy Savage.
You name him, you know, you go Macho, Hulk, Rock, Austin. He's got that one name, you know, Cena. These guys that you could just Punk. You know who they're talking
Punk,
about.
Not so much.
Maybe not yet. He's getting there.
Yeah.
But you name him, you know. Even if you don't know wrestling, oh, I've heard of that guy. Slim Jim commercials, Spider-Man.
He's been in everything. Bonesaw.
Yeah. I mean, the guy, hey, rest in peace.
Rest in peace, Macho Man.
So there you go. 2011.
You are terribly missed.
Yeah, big time, because that guy could have been one hell of a creative booker.
Yes.
Or something.
He could have been a road agent, a booker.
And I'll tell you what. One of the best matches I've ever seen had that guy in it. Probably my favorite. It's in the top two. Macho Steamboat WrestleMania 3.
Yep.
One of the best technical matches you've ever seen. And there you go. So yep. that was the big loss.
That is our
that's 2011.
Our biggest loss of 2011.
So as we wrap up 2000 as the New Year's music plays.
Yeah.
Thank you, producers here. 2012.
We know it's New Year's. That's enough.
We get it. The end of days is coming, 2012.
Oh, the end of days.
According to the Mayans, they could suck it.
End of days. Oh, we're going Wade Barrett with the end of days.
Yeah, Wade Barrett. That's a good day. There you go. 2012, what are we looking for? We've already mentioned Dolph Ziggler as a champ.
Dolph Ziggler is champion. Zack Ryder will continue to get pushed.
CM Punk still the man.
CM Punk. I'm anticipating the Cena heel turn.
I think so. I think we talked about this all year long on OTR.
People will say, oh, no, he won't turn heel. I think he will.
I think, honest to God, that the promos that they're coming up, and even my dad said while I was over in Cleveland this past week while there was no show, you know, he even mentioned they're kind of making this Cena, like, snapping thing. Like,
yeah.
Kane's getting in his head, and he's looking at the crowd like, ooh, maybe
I
should just
the whole thing with Roddy Piper, too, when he slapped him.
Yeah, I think it's starting to snap. So we'll see what happens in 2012.
Real quick, what's your New Year's resolution?
New Year's resolution to keep kicking ass on OTR.
Keep putting boots to asses.
Boots to asses like The Rock.
Mine's more realistic. I'm looking to lose some weight. Since I already stopped smoking, so that takes out one of my options. So I'm going to lose
a little bit of
weight.
And hopefully get paid by YouTube.
Hopefully.
You know what I'm saying? And hey, this Monday night
Big reveal of the January 2nd.
Who's going to be?
Who is it?
Your prediction right now.
Mine's saying Jericho.
I'm going to say Undertaker.
All right.
There you go. So there you go. So for Wes, I'm taping Thunder in Paradise. Burden.
He ain't here.
He'll be here next week. By the way, another OTR.
Yes, we are
this
back
Tuesday,
back on
so look for
normal,
Wednesday.
Normal schedule from here on out.
So Wednesday the 3rd, look
noted.
For it. Yep, otherwise noted. And for the one and only, the guy that's going to go raise hell tonight when the ball drops with Dick Clark, Troy Stone Cold Austin. And the one and only, I'm going to go home, drink beer, kick Ryan Seacrest in his...
And kick Ryan Seacrest in his lady parts.
In his lady parts.
Seacrest lady parts, now trending worldwide.
The one and only, Jason.
Bye-bye.
Yes. That's right. You have a happy new year. We'll catch
happy
you next week.
Have a safe one. No drinking and driving.
Right. We'll see
have
you next week.
One.
Outside the ring. Deuces.
Deuces.